Welcome back. The aim today is to give some background information on multiplication of inverse Laplace transform. First, I will give you an overview of multiplication of inverse Laplace transform, and later I'll look at the problems. See the theorem here related to the multiplication. It is the theorem of multiplication of inverse Laplace transform. If inverse Laplace transform of f of s is f of t, then inverse Laplace transform of s, if multiplied with f of s, then what we have to do? So we have to derive for one time. So if it's multiplied for two times, so we have to make a double derivative of f of t. So here we got f of t. See, if inverse Laplace transform of f of s is equal to f of t, then inverse Laplace transform of s into f of s is equal to f dash of t. From this we got f of t. So if 1s is there, we have to make one derivative. If 2s's are there, we have to make a double derivative of f of t. So this is the most important and very easy also. Whenever you see f of s is multiplied by s, we have to use the theorem on multiplication. So you have to remember that the multiplication theorem is most important. Here are some examples for you. See, by seeing the questions, you can easily identify that it is multiplied by s. It is multiplied with s in the numerator. Here there is s square. So we have to make double derivative of f of t. So here, after seeing the question, you can easily identify that these problems are related to the multiplication with s. So we have to use this theorem, that is s into f of s is equal to f dash of t. So these are most important, very easy and expected questions in the examination. So don't miss it and keep watching my video until the end. And here is one problem for you to solve. So how we have to solve this? Here there is a multiplication with s. So for that I'll write as inverse Laplace transform of s into 1 by s minus 4 whole power 5. So I have to leave s for some time and have to make this inverse Laplace transform of f of s. So inverse Laplace transform of what is f of s? It is nothing but s minus 4 whole power 5. We have to use, what we have to use? The first shifting theorem. So what is the first shifting theorem? States that inverse Laplace transform of f of s minus a is nothing but e power at into f of t. See here, it is f of t. So here I can write using first shifting theorem as e power 4t into inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s power 5. So what is the formula? What is the elementary formula for that? So inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s power n plus 1 is nothing but t power n by n factorial. In that, if I substitute here, so the answer will be e power 4t, that is t power, this is n plus 1. So I have n as 4 and this is 4 factorial. What is 4 factorial? 4 factorial is nothing but 1 into 2 into 3 into 4, which is equal to 24. Therefore, my inverse Laplace transform of f of s is ready as e power 4t into t power 4 by 24. So by multiplication theorem, what we have to do? By multiplication theorem, by applying the multiplication theorem. So what is the multiplication theorem here? Inverse Laplace transform of s into f of s is nothing but f dash of t. So I have to make one time derivative of this, which is nothing but this is f of t. So I have to make d by dt of f of t. What is f of t here? That is e power 4t into t power 4 by 24. So if I make a derivative, so it is of the form UV rule. So what is this UV rule? If I take this as U and if I take this as V, so derivative of U by V is nothing but you have to leave U for one time, you have to derive V, you again leave V and you derive U. So if I make like that, so it will be e power 4t. If I make derivative with this, that is 4 t cube plus, if I leave t power 4 and make derivative with this, that is 4 e power 4t. So this is how we have to make, and what factors I can take common. So I can take 4 t cube into e power 4t common from that, then it will be, everything is gone here, and here it will be 1, and here it will be t. So 1 plus t is left over. So the final answer for this is 4 into t cube e power 4t by 24 into 1 plus t is the final answer. So 1 plus t is the final answer. So what I have taken as common, see here, here 4 is there, and here e power t is also there. From this I can take t cube. So the minimum value is t cube. So see here, the first of all we have to identify that the question is of the form, it is multiplied with s. So I have to separate s. So I have to take only f of s. I have taken inverse Laplace transform of f of s, and using the first shifting theorem, which shifting theorem it is? First shifting theorem. According to the first shifting theorem, here is the formula I have applied in this, and it will become e power 4t inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s power 5. Again, by which formula you have to use? By this elementary function I have applied in this, that is e power 4t into t power 4 by 4 factorial. So 4 factorial is nothing but 1 into 2 into 3 into 4, which is equal to 24. So I got f of t value ready. So now using the multiplication theorem, it will be s into f of s. So what I have to do, I have to make one time derivative with f of t. So I have made a derivative d by dt of f of t. So it is of UV rule. So what is the formula of UV rule? So this is the formula I have applied, and I have taken 4 t cube e power 4t as common, then the value is 1 plus t. So this is how we have to solve using the multiplication theorem. These are most important problems. So the next problem is, you can do along with me. So you can say along with me. So it is also multiplication with s. So I have to separate it. How I'll write? That is s into 1 by s plus 3 whole square. See? So only I'll take this one, inverse Laplace transform of f of s, which is equal to inverse Laplace transform of 1 plus s plus 3 whole square. Now I have to apply the first shifting theorem. What is that first shifting theorem? Inverse Laplace transform of f of s minus a is nothing but e power a t into f of t. So if I apply, so it will be e power minus 3t inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s square. So what is this? Inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s square is nothing but, see here, the answer is t power 1 by 1 factorial. 1 by s power n plus 1 is nothing but t power n by 1 factorial. So this is equal to e power minus 3t into t by 1 factorial. Therefore, we got f of t value as t into e power minus 3t. Now, which theorem we have to apply? Multiplication theorem. So what the multiplication theorem statement states? This is multiplication theorem. Statement states that, see here, inverse Laplace transform of s into f of s. If it's multiplied with s, we have to derive f of t for one time. So I'll make derivative, that is d by dt of, what is f of t? F of t is nothing but t into e power minus 3t, that is t into e power minus 3t. Again, you have to apply UV rule. So I'll make UV rule with this. So which is equal to, I'll leave t for one time, I'll make derivative for t, and I'll leave v, and again I'll leave t, and what is the derivative of e power minus 3t is minus 3 e power minus 3t. So what is the answer? E power minus 3t minus t, 3t into e power minus 3t. So what I have to take common from this? If I take e power minus 3t as common, then it will be 1 minus 3t. What it is? Inverse Laplace transform of s into f of s. I got the value as e power minus 3t into 1 minus 1 by 3t. So this is how we have to solve. So this is that easy if you apply this theorem statement, that is after getting f of t we have to derive for one time. See the next problem for you. See inverse Laplace transform of s by s squared minus a squared. Clearly it is multiplied with s and separate, that is s into 1 by s squared minus a squared. Then what is f of s? We have to make the inverse Laplace transform of f of s, which is equal to inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s squared minus a squared. So we have a formula, direct formula from the elementary functions, as s square minus a square is nothing but 1 by a times of sine h a t. See here, if it's minus, it is hyperbolic function. If it's plus, it's a trigonometric function. Please remember that and write the answer as 1 by a into sine h a t, which is nothing but f of t. I got f of t value ready as 1 by a times of sine h a t. Now I have to apply multiplication theorem. So what the multiplication theorem statement states? After applying the multiplication theorem, so what the multiplication theorem statement states? Inverse Laplace transform of s into f of s is nothing but one time you have to make derivative. So that I'm going to do now, which is equal to d by dt of f of t. What is f of t? 1 by a times of sine h a t. So 1 by a is a constant. For sine h a t, it is cos h a t. Again for t 1, I'll write a. So if I cancel a for one time, the answer is cos h a t. Now the answer inverse Laplace transform of s by s square minus a square is cos h a t. So this is the most famous formulae, as you all know, that is inverse Laplace transform of s by s square minus a square is nothing but cos h a t. See once what I have done. So s into 1 minus s square minus a square, I have taken f of s as 1 by s square minus a square. From this formula I wrote 1 by a times of sine, this is sine h a t. So f of t is ready. If I apply multiplication theorem and if I substitute here, so after calculating I got inverse Laplace transform of s by s square minus a square as cos h a t. So last but not the least, so come let's all do together. So in this question, if you see, s is multiplied for twice, so you have to derive for two times. So I am taking out s square, that is s square into 1 by s minus 3 whole square. So what is inverse Laplace transform of f of s? See here, inverse Laplace transform of s minus 3 whole square. So I have to apply the first shifting theorem. According to the first shifting theorem, inverse Laplace transform of f of s minus a is nothing but e power a t into f of t. So if I apply, what will happen? It will be e power 3t inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s square. As you all know that inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s square is equal to t power 1 by 1 factorial. So that is e power 3t into t. So f of t is ready for with me, that is t into e power 3t. So now I have to apply the multiplication theorem. See, the multiplication theorem statement states that according to the multiplication theorem, what I have to do, inverse Laplace transform of s square into f of s is nothing but f double dash of t. I have to make derivative for two times, that is d square by dt square into f of t. F of t is nothing but t into e power 3t. So first time I'll make a derivative using UV rule. Let it be u and this is v. So one time t, the derivative of t is 1 and e power 3t plus t I'll leave and this is 3 into e power 3t. See, that is d by dt of e power 3t plus 3t into e power 3t. So d by dt of what I can take common? E power 3t, if I take common, it will be 1 plus 3t. Again, this is of the form UV rule. Again, if I make a UV rule, so this will be 3 into e power 3t. I have to leave 1 plus 3t. If I leave e power 3t, then what it will be? It will be 3. See here, it is, if I multiply 3 into e power 3t plus 3 3s are 9. T into e power 3t plus 3 times of e power 3t. Now 3 plus 3 is nothing but if I add up these two, 3 e power 3t and 3 e power 3t, it will be 6 e power 3t plus 9t e power 3t. Now what I can take common? So the common is 3. 3 table. If I take 3 into e power 3t, then 2 plus 3t is the final answer. See here, this is also very easy. It is multiplied with s square. So I have to make derivative for 2 times. So this is the rule, which rule I have used, that is, if you see, it is UV rule. So you have to leave U and derive V, and again you have to leave V and you have to derive U. This is how we have to solve, and the final answer is like this. So this is the easiest of all the formulae. So please make note of it. So I said to you once again, these are most important, very easy and expected questions in the examination. Thanking you so much for holding your attention till the end. And don't hesitate to subscribe, like, and share it to your friends. And leave a thumbs up down. Thank you.